Assalamualaikum and good afternoon. Okay, I think we can start our session for today, which we are going to focus on the exercises that I gave you yesterday. Okay, so we are going to discuss the answers. Okay, whether what you have done is right or not. Okay, before I show you the answers, I would like to ask some of you, what did you get based on your calculation? Okay, for the first part, which focusing on compound amount, okay, as stated in the slide, there are two questions for compound amount. Okay, the first questions, I would like to hear the answer from who's the luckiest one? Muhammad Akmal, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What do you get for question number one for compound amount?
We answer.
Aku nak kata ke?
No. Saya nak buka awal. Oh, saya dapat
34K.
Salah ke?
Tak apa, never mind. Nanti kita tengok.
Okay.
Thank you. Izzah Huma Mudin. Ada? Izzah? Ada? Soalan. Ini Izzah Ibrahim ni, bolehlah jawab-jawab. What did you get for question number one?
RM20,228.
Okay, that's your answer. Never mind, nanti kita akan tengok. Okay, question number two. What is your answer, Shazlina Zamri? Nak kena round off ke? Tak apa, nanti kita tengok. Shazlina Zamri, are you there? Azwan Arash, Azwan, hai, ramai pula live meeting. Jerome Bakar. Azwan,
Dapat RM19,143.
Ni nombor 2.
Oh, nombor 2. Dah.
Okey. Soalan mana sah, nombor 2 ke?
Nombor 2. Apa you dapat, Jerome?
1,914,000.
Okay, that's what you get. Okay, Azwan. Thank you, Jerome.
Okay.
I think 1.9 million. Alright, thank you.
Yes.
Alright, we will see the answers. Right. Second part of the exercise, we focusing on present words. Okay, question number one. Can someone give me the answers? Maybe Aina Awatif. Aina Awatif. Adi Iqbal. Are you there, Adi Iqbal?
Ada saya, ada saya. Kejap, saya tengah kira.
Baru nak kira?
Saya buat sampai compound mana nombor 2 je tadi.
Oh, okay. Sekejap. Ervina.
Apa, sir? Sorry.
Soalan number 1, question number 1 for present words.
You uniform, for present word? Number 1.
Yeah.
12,355.
All right, thank you.
Okay.
Question number 2. Mama Kemalda. Eldaria Diana. Eldaria Diana.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
1646.
1646. All right. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All right. For next exercises is on uniform series compound amount, okay, which consists of two questions also. Okay. For the question number 1, I would like to hear the answer from Marshall. Marshall John. Marshall, are you there?
Hello.
Yep. What are your answer for question number 1? Sorry, can you repeat?
40,806.
That's question number 1 for uniform series. Okay, thank you. Azhan Fikri. Question number 1, uniform series.
Question number 1.
Yeah.
Question number 1.
Uniform series.
41,000.
41,000. Okay.
Yeah.
Alright.
162.
Okay, never mind. Kita akan tengok nanti jawapan dia. Adi Iqbal pun tadi, nanti kita akan tengok balik jawapannya. Alright, kita move on to the second question for uniform series. Yang ini ada tricky little bit equations. Never mind. I will like to hear the answer from Ifah Shahira. Ifah Shahira, are you there? Nadra Aina, are you there?
Yes, sir. Soalan yang ni?
Soalan 2, uniform series.
Yang first
Nombor 2. Second.
Oh, nombor 2. Sekejap. Oh.
2, 3, 5, 8, 8, 7, 8, 3. 2, 3, 23 million. Something lah. 5, 8, 8, 7, 8, 3. Okay, alright, thank you. Okay. Alright, we move on to sinking fund deposit, which consists of two question as well. Okay, sinking fund, soalan pertama, Mama Farhan, Mama Ayub ada. Tak ada. Mama Farhan, Mama Ayub. Tak ada. Senyap je. Patrice.
Hello.
Ya,
Patrice. Soalan 1. 6141.
6141.
Yeah.
Alright, thank you.
Okay.
Question number 2, Afi. Afi Afzal.
Hello, sir. Good evening.
Yeah, yeah.
Question number 2, right?
Yeah.
RM 8,744.
Alright, thank you.
Alright.
Okay, we move on to the second last question on present words uniform siri. Ada satu soalan ni guys tu. Okay, Hazim Hadi.
Saya dapat 7,581.60.
Okay, alright. Thank you. The last question, capital recovery uniform series. Courtney. Courtney.
Sir, yeah. Still calculating.
Still calculating.
Okay.
Yeah. Danish.
Me too, sir. Sama.
Sama. Eusebius Paul.
Sama juga, sir.
Sama juga. Farhan. Dua kali dah saya panggil Farhan ni. Ada tak ada ni?
Sama, sir. Tengah kira.
Sama juga.
Saya nak jawab, sir.
Okay, siapa nak jawab? Nabil lah.
Last kan? Capital recovery uniform series, sir.
Ah, ya. Yeah.
Saya dapat 2,588.24.
Okay, right. Okay, thank you. Okay, let's check your answer. Whether betul atau tak. Kita tengok. Okay, nampak? Slide here.
Nampak.
Alright.
Nampak saya.
Hari ni tak hujan, sepatutnya tak delay. Belum hujan lagi. Okay, kita tengok first part, okay, which is focusing on compound amount. Okay, the first question is stated that if you had RM5,000 now and invested it at 15% interest compounded annually, how much would it be worth in 10 years time? I don't want to join. Sekejap. Okay. Okay, as I mentioned yesterday, it is advisable for you to draw a simple diagram so that you can get a better view on what you need to find based on this question. Okay, the interest is 15%, the numbers of years is 10. Okay, so you want to invest 5,000 ringgit, that's your provisional sum. Okay, that's what you want to invest today. Okay, what you want to find is the sum, which is S. Okay, so the total amount of money that you will get after 10 years with 15% interest. So you apply the first formula yang kita belajar semalam. Okay, so masukkan dalam formula, you will get roughly 20,228 ringgit. Roughly lah. Okay, kita tadi ada tanya nak bundarkan ke apa ke. So kita bundarkan lah. So especially bila you tekan calculator ni, sampai kita bundarkan dia agak berbeza-beza sedikit lah jawapan dia. Tapi tak adalah if jauh sangat, you dapat 30,000 something wrong lah. So you boleh double check your calculation later. So this slide I will upload in your future after this session . Nanti kita boleh, you boleh tengok balik. Alright, second question is 1.5 million is deposited in a bank today for 5 years at a compound interest of 5% per year. So what is the amount in the account at the end of 5 years? Okay, so sama. Interest is 5%, duration is 5 years. So you want to invest 1.5 million today, which is your provisional sum. So you want to know what you're going to get after 5 years. So you need to find the S. We apply the same formula. Put in the formula and you will get roughly around 1.9 million. Okay, roughly lah. Okay, kalau you dapat 1.9 million something tu, doesn't matter. Okay, just roughly je. Okay. So later nanti you can double check your calculation. Okay, next is present word. All right, the first question. Okay, present word. The question is, an investor's bank statement shows a credit of 50,000 as a result of small investment made 10 years previously. So interest rate is, or interest over this period is 15%. What was the original investment? So here, you know the total sum of money that you have currently. So what you're looking at is your initial investment. What is your provisionally you invest in that bank? So you know the S value, which is 50,000. You need to find the P value, which is your provisional sum of money that you have invested 10 years ago. Okay, so this is the formula. So put it in the formula, then you will get 12,359. So that's what you get. That's what you invested 10 years ago in this bank. Okay, so after 10 years, you got 50,000. Okay, so that's how you calculate this present worth. Okay, the second question, how much must you invest now to provide a lump sum of 2,000 ringgit for your college fees at the end of 4 years? If from now, the interest rate is 5%. So you want to have 2,000 ringgit in your account for the next 4 years. Okay, so the interest is 5%. So you want to have, as I mentioned earlier, 2,000 ringgit in your account after 4 years. So how much you need to invest today? Okay, so you need to find the provisional sum, put in the formula, you get 1,645 ringgit roughly. All right, so that's the amount of money that you need to put in the bank account today, so that after 4 years you will get 2,000 ringgit. Okay. Okay. Right, next part is uniform series compound amount. There are two questions also. Okay, the first question is, given an interest rate of 5% per year, what sum would be accumulated after 6 years if 2,000 ringgit were invested at the end of each year for 6 years? So interest is 5%, duration is 6 years. So you are going to regularly put 2,000 ringgit every year for the next 6 years. Okay, so setiap tahun you simpan 2,000 selama 6 tahun. So you nak tahu selepas 6 tahun berapa banyak you dapat dengan interest 5%. Okay, so this is the formula. So the regular sum is 2,000 ringgit, which is you are going to put in the bank each year for the next 6 years, which interest 5%. So you will get 13,604 ringgit roughly after 6 years. Okay, so selepas you simpan 2,000 ringgit setiap tahun selama 6 tahun. Okay, so that's how you calculate this uniform series compound amount. Second question. Okay, ini a little bit tricky. Okay, builders buys a site near an industrial area in a large city for 2 million. Okay, so you as a builder, you buy a site for 2 million ringgit. So the site requires outgoing cost every year. That includes the maintenance cost 30,000 ringgit, fencing cost 10,000 ringgit, and washing cost 5,000 ringgit every year. So means that your ongoing cost for every year for maintaining this site is roughly about 45,000. You kena spend every year. Okay? Untuk jaga you punya site. So dekat sini dia ada dua formula yang you kena cari. First, the next question is estimated that the site will not be sold for the next 10 years. Okay, the target 10 tahun untuk jual. Tapi however, selepas 8 tahun dia terasa nak jual. Maybe they need some money and so on. So they are looking at the minimum price that the site must be sold. pay if the cost that has been invested 10% per year. The interest is 10% per year. Okay. So here, the first one you need to look at is the cost of the land yang you kena dapat balik. So, and the second one is the outgoing cost yang you spend every year selama 8 tahun. Okay, so kat sini. Okay, so the dua, there are two things that you need to calculate. The first one is the compound amount. Okay, so you invested, you have invested 2 million. You invested 2 million for this site. Okay, so after 8 years with the interest of 10%, you want to know what is the exact amount that you the minimum amount that you can sell that site. Okay, so that's the price of the site itself. Okay, so you calculate it, so you get 4.29 million. So this is the minimum cost. Okay, the minimum cost, right, the minimum cost for the site itself, 4.29 million. Itu untuk tanah saja, untuk site saja yang you beli. You spend 2 million tadi. So next, you also spend on outgoing cost that involve maintenance, okay, fencing and washing cost, okay, which total 45,000. So that's the amount of money that you spend every year, setiap tahun untuk selama 8 tahun. Okay, so you spend 45,000 untuk maintenance cost, fencing cost and washing cost. So you need to know berapa sepatutnya pulangan you dapat selepas you invest 45,000 setiap tahun untuk 8 tahun. So you gunakan formula apa formula tadi? Uniform series compound amount ni. Okay, you masukkan dalam formula. So you will get 514,614. Okay, that's sepatutnya pulangan yang you dapat balik selepas you spend on outgoing cost every year ni 45,000. So therefore, the minimum price is the total of 4.2 million plus 500 plus ni, you akan dapat lebih kurang 4.8 million. So that's the minimum cost of selling this site. Okay, minimum price that you boleh request. Okay, cannot be less than that. Kalau less than that, perhaps you alami kerugian lah. Okay, so that's the way you calculate this question. Ada yang dapat betul? Anyone?
Tak ada.
Apa what you did is you lamsamkan semua, tambah semua, then you calculate tu yang dapat sampai 23 billion million tadi. Okay, so read the question carefully lah later on. Okay, never mind. Next, we move on to the sinking fund deposit, which consists of two questions as well. A uniform annual investment is to be made into a sinking fund with a view to provide the capital at the end of 7 years for the replacement of a tractor. The interest rate is 5%. What is the annual investment needed to buy the tractor at the price of 15,000? Okay. So the interest is 5% and the total number of years is 7. So you are looking at how much you need to spend or to save every year for the next 7 years. So that you can get 15,000, so that you'll be able to buy the tractor. So you use the formula of sinking fund deposit. We are looking at regular sum, okay, yang kita bayar every year for the next 7 years. Masukkan dalam formula, you will get RM6,141. That's the amount of money that you have to save in the bank account for every year for the next 7 years, so that you'll be able to buy the tractor at the value of 15,000. Okay, second question. Your father wants to set up a college plan for your sister. She is currently 10 years old and will go to the college at the age of 18. So you have 8 years roughly. Okay, so your father assumed that when she starts college, she will need at least 100,000 in the bank. So how much do your father need to save each year in order to have the necessary fund if the current interest rate is 10%? Okay, sama juga konsep dia. Okay, we are looking at duit yang kena simpan every year for the next 8 years. Okay, 8 years. Okay, selepas sebab sekarang ni adik you umur 10 tahun. So, pada 18 tahun baru dia masuk college, so you ada 8 tahun. So, gunakan formula yang sama, you will get roughly RM8,744. Okay? Right, the next one is present works uniform ciri. Okay, how much money is needed to be deposited in the bank in order to provide 5 equal annual withdrawal of RM2,000? Okay, the first of which will be met 1 year after the deposit. Okay, interest is 10%. Okay, here kita nak cari berapa duit initially yang kita kena letak dalam bank sekarang. Supaya selepas ni, every 5 years kita boleh keluar RM2,000 setiap tahun. Okay. Gunakan formula present worth uniform series. Letakkan dalam formula. So you get RM7,582 roughly. So duit ni lah you kena simpan sekarang. So that starting from next year, you boleh withdraw RM2,000 setiap tahun selama 5 tahun. Okay, dengan interest 10%. Okay, the last one, capital recovery uniform series. If with an interest rate of 5%, what uniform end of period payment must be met for 10 years to repay an initial debt of RM2,000. Okay, you ada hutang RM2,000. Okay. So, you kena bayar setiap tahun. Okay. Selama 10 tahun. So, you nak kena tahu berapa banyak you kena bayar setiap tahun untuk settlekan hutang RM2,000 ni selama 10 tahun. Okay, gunakan formula capital recovery uniform series. Okay, so means that you kena ada dalam bank RM259. Okay, so maksudnya you boleh bayar hutang ni RM2,000 selepas 10 tahun. Okay, so that's how you calculate capital recovery uniform series. Okay. Tambah dapat semua betul? Ada?
Tak ada, sir.
Tak ada?
Salah
tiga. Salah tiga? Bercedok.
Yang penting cuba, sir.
Ya, yeah, betul. Yang penting cuba. Salah tak apa. Okay. So, untuk mengukuhkan lagi you punya understanding, let's have a short quiz. Okay, get ready with your pen and also calculator. Okay, boleh nampak slide ni?
Boleh, sir.
Boleh?
Boleh, sir.
Boleh,
sir. Okay, get ready. Are you ready?
Ada extra mark, sir.
Yes.
Ya, ini tak ada extra mark nanti later untuk naikkan grade you. Okay, yes, I'm ready, okay? Be confident, you can do it. Alright, there are 3 questions which need to be completed within 20 minutes starting jam set time. Timer. Okay, start from now. And that's the formula. Try what? Sekejap eh. Saya offkan kamera dengan Minit ni. Tak keluar entah. Jangan risau. Okay, time's up. Time's up. Siap tak?
Siap tak?
Boleh dah tu.
Boleh lah. I'm going to write down the answer here. You can check later. Question 2. Question 3. Okay. So, you double check your answer. Question 1. Sama.
Sama tu.
Ada yang tak dapat? Lain? Okay, kalau sama alhamdulillah. Boleh lah. Dah tu dapat lah. Faham lah sikit macam mana nak kata. Okay. For those yang tak dapat jawab ataupun lain jawapan, kalau ada, so you boleh double check later on. So jawapan saya dah beri dia, saya boleh try calculate balik. Okay, maybe ada. Kalau tak dapat juga boleh PM saya lah. Okay, I think if you understood the formula, apa yang nak kena cari, S ke P ke R, I think you don't have any problems to calculate lah actually. Okay, so I will end the session to this. Okay, so before I end the class, I would like to remind you that you have roughly one more hours before the submission for assignment 2 close. So for those yang belum submit, please do so. Okay, sebelum kompat, kita akan tutup kompat ni dalam. So please submit before 4 PM for your assignment 2. Okay, saya bagi, I think about 1 week should be enough lah sebenarnya. Dah seminggu saya bagi sebenarnya. Saya buka seminggu dah. So, next week will be your midterm break. So, it's time for you to refresh. Okay, take the time off from study. Maybe kalau ada assignment boleh siapkan ke yang mana yang assignment yang subject lain ke. So, I will see you again after the midterm break. So, we will continue week 8 which focusing on lecture 8. Again, there is more calculation that you're going to learn after this lah. Okay, so roughly for lecture 7, I hope you understand on how to investigate the relationship between interest and sultan. So for your future punya decision making, okay, for your personal life or maybe for your companies as well. Okay, so Nak solat dari pagi sampai malam saya senang diri. Okay, so take your time off lah for next week. One week, you have an opportunity to break for one week. Okay, even though we cannot go anywhere. Okay, maybe some of you ada yang dekat zone. Macam saya Selangor ni susah lah nak bergerak. Okay, maybe ada some of you dekat area Johor ke apa ke, bebas sikit bergerak. So, take your time off lah. Okay, so thank you for your time. Okay, see you after the midterm break. Take care, stay safe, stay at home.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you, sir. Stay safe.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.